in the shadow of the West LA skyline, tucked under the 405 at Venice Boulevard, is a stretch of sidewalk some 40 people call home. At least once a week, the LAPD orders them out, blocks off the area, and an army of sanitation workers moves in, picking up used needles, bottles of urine, and mountains of garbage. They sanitize the sidewalk and then leave. But within minutes, people are back, rebuilding their life under the 405. The sidewalk is again littered with the hazardous byproducts of life on the streets. You're living out here by choice.
Oh, 100%.
We met Dylan Brumley rummaging through the trash here in search of something to eat. And we saw him picking up a dirty needle.
Well, you're gonna use that needle?
Yes.
He says these cleanups never keep the area clean for more than a few hours.
You're wasting time, money, effort.
And neighbors who live near the encampment agree.
It is not a good use of our tax dollars.
Roman Samily lives five houses from the tent city. He says when the cops force the homeless people out during those cleanups, they move into the neighborhood, leaving behind piles of garbage, which the sanitation workers never clean up.
But it just pushes the trash into our streets. Our streets are worse after these cleanups.
And worse because of this too. The homeless routinely leave their encampment to urinate on the streets of the neighborhood, and they defecate on the residential streets where children play. When sanitation workers do their cleanups, they stay inside the yellow tape, ignoring piles of human waste just a few feet away.
People are defecating and urinating all over the streets. You're aware of this?
Yes.
Pepe Garcia of LA's Department of Sanitation.
If you have a pile of feces a few feet outside an encampment, they should clean it up.
They should.
Garcia is in charge of these cleanups, which are supposed to ensure healthier conditions in and around these tent cities.
That's the main goal.
But that's not happening, say neighbors who live near this homeless encampment in the valley, near this one in Echo Park, and the people who overlook this one in Hollywood.
If you come back the day afterwards, after a major cleaning, it looks the same or worse.
The I-team obtained and analyzed records of all homeless encampment cleanups and found the city conducted nearly 15,000 of those cleanups last year alone. That cost taxpayers $31 million just to pay the sanitation workers, another $4.7 million to pay the cops assigned to protect them. And no one could tell us the cost of DOT officers who control traffic around the cleanups, or the cost of these city outreach workers who hand out snacks.
What's the total cost of the cleanups?
I wouldn't have that number for you.
Is there anyone in the city keeping track of the total cost of these cleanups?
I wouldn't be able to comment. I don't know.
There's an absolute better way that the city could be spending all this money.
Homeless advocate Becky Dennison and infectious disease doctor Jeffrey Klausner of UCLA have been to the 405 encampment and say conditions like these are a breeding ground for disease.
There have been outbreaks like Shigella, Salmonella, E. coli, hepatitis A.
Dr. Klausner says the city should use some of that cleanup money to place porta potties at every big encampment, something they've done at just 12 out of the hundreds of tent cities in LA.
Going to the restroom is just a basic human need, and it does create a health crisis to not have a bathroom.
And she says the city needs to place a lot more trash cans near homeless encampments. At that 405 site, there's just one can on each end of the encampment, and they're always overflowing.
How many trash cans should the city put out at that encampment?
At least six or seven, or a larger dumpster.
Trash is not the issue.
Dylan Brumley has another idea. He thinks the city could redirect some of those cleanup dollars to offering drug treatment to addicts like himself and help for the mentally ill, help that could get these people off the streets for good.
With the millions of dollars that they're spending on the trash pickup, I don't think it would be impossible to have some sort of counseling.
If you go in and you clean up these encampments and they're dirty again within hours?
This is the best I can do today. Will it get better tomorrow? I absolutely believe it will.
In the wake of our investigation, sanitation officials tell us they will retrain their workers to clean up trash and human waste in the neighborhoods around encampments, not just near the tents. We'll be watching in the months and years to come to see how your tax dollars are being spent to clean up LA's streets of shame.